Baron von Esskay. Remember him? Esskay.
Yeah, look, more tins.
Watch your step here. Yeah.
Below this 4,600 square foot art gallery photographic studio is the original Esskay slaughterhouse, where there's a tunnel that goes about 30 feet and stops with a brick wall. At one point we want to break it open and see what's beyond it, where the pigs came in and through the tunnel, where they lived the last of their happy lives down there and turned out to be pork. But our vision is to resurrect that space into artist studios that'll be subsidized for artists leaving the Maryland Institute or whatever for a certain period of time. Because often you leave school, they kick you out of the nest, they slap you on the back, and there's no opportunity to let me kill that.
What's our the Bee Gees. It's a nice
killing. It was a nice soundtrack to the pigs living out there last
Hello.
How are you?
So, this is the slaughterhouse where Schluderberg and Kurdle merged the companies. It's the first one where Esskay meatpacking took place here. And our vision is long-term to turn this into artist studios. So it'll be, you know, subsidized, inexpensive studios for artists to create in their first year out of college or at a time in life where it's appropriate. And, you know, it'll be the slaughterhouse studio.
Smells like a basement.
Yes, that's clearly one of the challenges we face. We got to decide, do we, you know, lower the floor, keep the original floor? This is the tunnel that when we first came in here had these cool doors that opened and closed. And since we were knuckleheads, we didn't value them. I don't know where they went. But that is the original entrance for our the pigs. And my understanding was the reason they did that, at one point they used to herd them down the alley. The alley behind our building currently is called Benefit Alley. Its original name was Hog Alley, because they would herd the hogs down that alley and they would turn the corner on Dean Street, which I don't think was called Dean Street then either. But when they would turn the corner, if the pigs got ahead of the people herding them, they would disappear into the houses. And the families could eat for, you know, 2 or 3 weeks or months on whatever the catchings were. So to cut down on the inventory shrinkage during transport from the train station, they created some kind of a elaborate system of tunnels.
Wow, so this tunnel right here is... So they would come right from the trains to here?
Somehow, and you know...
How far down does that go? Not that I want to go down there.
No, I mean, truthfully, there's a brick wall. And
oh, brick
we
wall.
Don't know what's beyond that.
Oh, beyond the brick wall. It's like, you know.
Yeah, I've seen pictures of this street from 100 years ago. And the building that sits on, that's there, was there. So that building's quite old, so I don't know exactly did it turn, what happened, or how that was utilized. But, that's part of the whole thing.
Jeez.
And yeah, my vision is, you know, once this is emptied and possibly the floor lowered and obviously the humidity issues resolved, is maybe the studios have glass fronts, you know, glass walls with little holes in them, like Silence of the Lambs, you know, hello, Clarice. And you can see the art going on.
Yeah, there's the hole.
Motivate people. And well, that's our elevator pit. We just resurrected that.
An elevator? Oh, look at it.
That's the elevator. I mean, that's the real deal. Elevator with a refrigerator on it. But, there's actually some interesting, crazy graffiti that unfortunately a lot of it has been lost since the last year. I mean, lost since we moved in. Yeah, Knights of the Klan, no doubt. Yeah, you got some racist the 80-year-old racist graffiti.
That is quite a shaft.
So this shaft would go up to...
Look up here.
Yeah, it goes up
to the roof. Oh, my.
So if it goes up one floor, we can pop an entrance.
Wow! Whoa! Oh, my.
Look at that.
Just one of the doors that were down here, which ballyhoes the 1952 Orioles. Maybe that was the year they came or whatever, but we've got some championships along the way. Our printing company actually had the privilege of printing for the 83 champions. We've done all sorts of fun screen printing for championship teams.
Golly, so this was... There's a hook.
There's a hook.
I'm sorry, you were saying what happened?
Well, but if you look, well, you can see it right here. There seems to be the sections like that. So my guess is each one of those sections were blocked off. The reason this was higher was so that all the whatever...
entrails.
Yeah, all the excess got washed into the things, and they were let into each one of these little sections. And spent the last... last moments of their lives. But, I'm guessing... And when we did come, there were some, you know, we've moved radiators and found Esskay boxes and Esskay packaging material that fell behind things.
Wow.
But,
they packaged it all here and put it in, you know.
Yeah, at that point, again, this was a, the company grew so fast. When they built that facility in, it opened, I think, in 1925 on Baltimore Street. Mm. It was, you know, 20 times the size of this.
Wow.
You take a good shot of what's happening and what the structure is. It all looks like plaster when in reality it's cork, natural cork insulation and plaster on top of it.
Wow.
The way they would have done it.
Wow. So this was
years ago. This was as close to refrigeration as they had. So we've tried to not, you know, damage that much of it.
Interesting. Very interesting. Well,
this will be the Slaughterhouse Studios where they create killer artwork. Then when they're finished through a period of time, they'll be the artists will have a showing in the gallery, which is right above here in the SK gallery space, or we call it the Skyloft Gallery. And SK was apparently a great place to work. You have a lot of positive things, unless of course you were a pig. Then it was a rough place to work. But it was a lot of nice history in this building, and we would like to continue to build on that as we create it into a cohesive group of artists.